What's going on, y'all? Cordero here.
Monica.
And today we are in downtown Dallas, and we're going to talk about some things that we did for our nursing interview. Action.
Hi, y'all. Welcome, a couple nurses.
What position did you apply for?
So on my cover letter, I applied for three positions. I did ICU. I did acute care trauma and as well as ER, so it's kind of like the same thing, basically ICU and ER. So those are the three that I put in my cover.
So I went on my interviews yesterday, or I think it was 2 days ago.
It was a legit interview.
Yeah, I had two interviews. So one of the questions that I got in both my interviews.
My interview is actually going to be on Thursday, so get a wishes from me. Whoop, whoop. Okay, back to Cordero. He's going to give
you. Monica, you want to go ahead and pop it off with some questions?
Yeah, I was actually looking at one of the comments that I received from the video. It's from Why Lexus Singleton, and you asked what to wear for an interview. That's a great question. First of all, I went to Express to get a suit. It was a little pricey, but I feel like it's a good investment into something that's, you know, gonna start off your career. So definitely dress professional, look the best that you can, go light on your makeup. I wore my hair down just like this, slicked down in a, actually like a sock bun, and just like some pearls, and that was it. I kept it very basic, yet professional and sleek. So I feel like that's an important question that you asked.
All right, so now that Monica told you guys what to wear, I'm gonna tell you guys what to wear from a guy's perspective. And I pretty much had a Kenneth Cole blue suit, navy blue. I got it probably about a year and a half, 2 years ago, slim fit. And then I had a checkered collared shirt underneath it. And then I had just a very nice looking tie. I like to wear a tie just to kind of definitely hold that, you know, professional look, especially going in as your first nurse. And especially me personally being a minority, I want to come bringing my best, you know, to the table. You know, had some nice shoes. I polished them the night before, made sure everything was ironed. So really just try to be as presentable as I could be. Okay, and the second tip I'm gonna give you guys is I had two interviews, and both questions they asked in both of my interviews was, tell me a little bit about yourself.
That is the most dreadful question ever.
And be prepared for that, because even like knowing that that was coming, I still wasn't ready for it. But that's your time to kind of like sell yourself.
Absolutely.
You know, that's whenever you kind of want to tell them what you're about, what are your values, what makes you a good nurse for them.
What makes you stand out on top of all the hundreds or thousands of applicants that they're going through when they ask you that question? I personally like it when they ask me that question or something around that question. I like to try to think of an answer that can answer multiple questions throughout the interview. So that's my time where I'm talking like their ears off. I make sure I'm confident, yet teachable, approachable, just very comfortable in my own skin and making sure that I know what I'm talking about. They can definitely sense the vibe in there, so just make sure that you're truthful and honest. And I think a good tip is also take some time to think about the question that they ask you. You don't always have to, you know, pop off and answer that question immediately, so take your time. So a question that I want to address is, I got asked, it's not exact, but it was around the same lines of, tell us about a difficult time where you were at your job. You basically thought your way out of it and you learned a lesson. That's a super important question, because it shows that even though that you screwed up, they're looking for you to answer, okay, how did you manage to get out of the situation successfully and truthfully? So I gave an example about whenever I was waiting tables at my restaurant, and I ended up cashing out the wrong table with the other table's card. The customers ended up leaving the restaurant. I told them, hey, I went to management first. I went there right away. We handled the situation. I had to give up some of my money in order to complete the other person's check. And that showed them that, okay, this person's responsible, they're honest, and they're willing to fix the situation now, which is super important in healthcare, instead of waiting till the last minute till something happens to the patient and the situation was flipped on a patient scenario. So that's a really important question to keep in mind. Okay, so another important tip for you guys that are starting to get closer to your graduation for your residency applications, is in your cover letter, make sure you add at least your top three spots that you would like to work in.
And the next tip I'm going to give you guys is to think about your letter's recommendation. That's something that I didn't think was going to be that big, that they're going to take into account, but it was huge for me. So before I even went in, they were like, we looked at your letter's recommendation, we saw that you played sports, and we saw that you work very well in the team. So definitely keep your connections now, whether that be clinical instructors, whether that be preceptors you have, whether that be your job. Make sure that you establish those connections now, and whenever you can, ask for a letter of recommendation, because they do matter, and the people recruiting you are going to read those.
So the next thing that I want to give you guys is a question that I came across during my mock interview, and the actual interview was, what are some strengths and what are some weaknesses about yourself? Of course, everybody can answer the strengths part about that, because that's almost like the similar question. Tell us a little bit about yourself. So you're able to answer all the positive aspects about yourself when you talk about yourself on that first question, then you'll cover the strengths. Now the weakness is where it gets tough. What you do want to do is absolutely don't say that you don't have any negative aspects about yourself, because that's going to make them wonder. They want to look for somebody that's been through something and that they were able to manage their way out and learn their lesson. Something that you can always work on, whether it's patience, whether it's, you know, not spending so much time on a specific topic or anything like that. That's a question that you really need to do some deep research within yourself to try to figure out how you're going to answer this question so you don't affect the way that they view you in the interview.
The next tip I'm going to give you guys is think about power words in your resume, and think about power words in your whenever you're talking to them. So these are things like teamwork, these are things like learning, like knowledge, like bettering yourself. Show that you're open to learn more. Say that you're teachable, and and all that good stuff. Those are things that they want to hear a lot. I told them that I was very detail-oriented and I was very good at communicating, and these are things that are going to transfer regardless of where you are in your nursing. So even as a new nurse, if you're able to tell them that you can communicate to patients and their families about their disease processes, that looks good to them.
All right, guys, so this is one of the most important questions, in my opinion, is where do you see yourself in 5 years, okay? That was asked in my interview, that was asked in Cordero's interview, that was asked in my mock interview, and what they're looking for is that you're a good investment and you're not going to want to, you know, continue education and leave them in the next, you know, 1 or 3 years. They want to make sure that they're making a good investment on this person to make sure that, you know, it makes you seem like you're more worth hiring. So I answered, hey, like, I see myself in this facility, you know, maybe becoming an educator at some point, which is true, it wasn't lies. So make sure that that's something that you want to do and also be true to yourself.
Alright guys, I hope that we were able to help you out with our tips. You in there?
Yeah, I don't know. I think I am.
With our tips. We should get a call back within a week or two as if we get hired, so we'll definitely keep you guys updated.
Cross your fingers, you guys. There's about 5 more residency applications that we've gone through already, so now we're waiting on them to actually email us for interview days, but as of now, we both interviewed with one of the top hospitals that we want to work with, so keep your fingers crossed. Say some good, whatever you believe in, you know, say some good something,
good wishes, good blessings.
Manifestations out there for us, so we really appreciate you tuning in, and we're definitely going to keep you in through this journey of ours so we can inform y'all on what to expect as future nurses.
If you liked it, comment Nurses Rock and give us a thumbs up. Peace.